Hi, and welcome to Talk Straight Bible. I'm your host, Jeremiah Zantonetti. We're still in Put Your Faith in the Torah. And for those who are listening maybe for the first time, it's a title that I chose because of something that I heard from a Jewish young rabbi that I got a chance to hang out with for a little while. And he actually backslid from the position of being, you know, among the community of Jewish people, and he wanted to go to California, and he wanted to have fun. And before he left, his father kept urging him, who was a rabbi, father, he said, son, put your face in the Torah, for there you will find life. And so he remembered those words when he backslid, and it taunted him. It burned it in his heart. And he finally came back and put his face in the Torah, and now he's a rabbi. Wow. So this whole series on Psalms 119, the whole 176 verses, we're going to try to cover them all by God's grace. It's all about putting your face in the Torah, the law of God, the very ascribed commandments of God. We still live by the commandments. And so, as a matter of fact, someone said about, you know, we're not saved by the commandments. I say, well, we're saved by the blood of Christ. But tell me, which commandment shouldn't you follow? You know, do not honor God. Take his name and dishonor it. Make false images. You know, don't keep the holy day. Do not honor your father and your mother. You know, do not steal. Which one shouldn't we keep? Well, we have to keep them because we want to keep them because we're saved. And that's the whole concept of it. But now, we're still in the second verse of Vav. Vav is the sixth letter in the Hebrew alphabet. And so if you go to 40, you will find that it starts with 41, Vav. And then we're moving on to the second part, which is Psalms 119, verse 42. And let's read. And I shall have something to answer him who mocks me, for I trust in your word. King James Version says, so shall I wherewith to answer him that reproach me, for I trust in thy word. Now, what's interesting is that the word here, you know, that I'll have something to say is the word, the Hebrew word, debar, debar. We've discussed this a few times, and you're going to hear it much more. But debar, again, has three Hebrew letters which represent three pictures. Remember, all the Hebrew letters have a picture, and that's what helps us to understand what it means. Now, again, this is the basics. These Bible studies, because they're short, it's just the tip of the iceberg. But let's go. Debar. The first letter is the dalet, which means a door. The bet, which is the second letter, means a house or a dwelling place, a tent. And then the resh, which is the R, represents a head, actually the back of a head, okay? Or the head of a person who's a leader, the beginning. So now it says that I will have a word, a debar. I will have a thing to say. I will utter something to the one that disrespects me. How is he disrespected? Well, he says he's going to answer him because he is one that reproaches. But the word answer here is three letters, and it's ana, okay? And it's a perspective, a picture of an eye. The next letter is a picture of a fish, and the last letter is a picture of a window. So can you picture that, okay? It's an eye that looks at a person. A fish is a people, or looks at a person, and responds out of a window. Why do we respond out of a window? Because when they're mocking us, we should not leave the territory that God has placed around us to confront them. We stay at the window of God's protection and answer the enemy from within. We don't have to go out to the enemy because the enemy cannot come in. He wants us to come out of our protective perimeter so that he can attack. See, so if we stay inside where we're protected by the shepherd, then we can answer those who taunt us, those who come against us. We can answer them righteously by a debar, a word, a thing, a matter, an utterance of God. Remember that the word of God gives you plenty of military power. You have a lot of arsenal in the word of God. And so people are going to mock you in this world. They mock Jesus. They mocked the disciples. They mocked Paul. So remember that when people mock you, do not take it as strange. Oh, they're mocking me because they're mocking you because you are a Christian, because you believe in God and you follow God. But God gives you the debar, his word, so that you can answer their reproach. Let's look at the word reproach. The reproach means, again, a taunt, a blasphemy. It means to rail you. It means to upbraid you. Watch this. It means to remain as a constant threat to you. So remember that people are going to come against you because of the faith, because you trust. Now, this is the part really I want to get to. For I trust in your word. Now, what's interesting about the word trust, there are three letters here. But let me go back real quick to the word reproach and just shine out those three letters, okay? And it's basically harath, and it means this. It's a barrier or a protection which brings us out, leads us out to something that is said. So that, again, getting to a place where you stay in the protective barrier of God's word and God's laws and God's commands, and don't let the enemy come into that perimeter. You answer from outside, from the inside to the outside. Amen. Now, the word here, trust, is bitkath. Bitkath. Actually, ha, for those who hear that. Okay? And it's three letters. There is the vet, or the bet, the house. There is a T, which is the tet, and it represents a snake. Okay? But it also represents the word good comes from that, because the tab means good, but it also represents a fence, something that's around you. Now watch this. Bitakha. I had an experience a few years ago. I was in a hospital visiting somebody, and there was a Jew there. It was I turned around and asked him. I said, "What does faith mean to you?" And he said something that really was interesting. He said, "We don't really use the word faith as people do." He said, there's two words, and there is imuna, which means faith, but then there's bitakha, which means trust, because you have an experience with God. And I found that very interesting. Right away, I began to say imuna. I said, boy, see, imuna, he said, is a knowledge-based faith, something that you know about. But bitakha, this word trust, is something that you had an experience with. Now, the Bible tells us that Abraham, the Lord came to Abraham in a vision. He brought the word in a vision, and he told Abraham that he was going to have as many descendants as the stars in the sky. And what's interesting is, after this dialogue, if you look at Genesis chapter 15, verse 6, the Bible says that Abraham believed God, and God counted it to him as righteousness. Now, what's interesting is the word believe there. It is the first time, in my discovering, looking at it, the first time that the word amen appears in the Bible, because the word believe there in the Hebrew is amen. And it means to trust. It means something that is firm. It means something that cannot be shakable. It's unshakable. So when you look at this word here, trust, bitka, it means something that is firm, because you had an experience with God. Now also, whenever you see a word for the first time in the Bible, it's called the law of first mention, meaning it's the first time it was mentioned. For example, the word covenant is mentioned for the first time in Genesis chapter 9 with Noah. After that, we have many occurrences of the word covenant. But for the first time is mentioned in Genesis 9, that is called the law of first mention. The word believe is found for the first time in Genesis chapter 15, verse 6. It is the law of first mention. And it is the word amen. And it starts with the first aleph, which means God, Yahweh. So he understood that Yahweh was speaking to him, and it was credited to him as righteousness. So we find also, for example, the word worship for the first time in Genesis chapter 22. Again, the law first mentioned. Here the word trust is very interesting, because it means to have confidence and to be secure. So he said, I have something to answer those who reproach me, and that is your word, because I trust in your word. I trust in what you said is firm, and it cannot be moved. Sometimes I use the same scripture for a particular temptation that comes to me. I use the same scripture all the time, and all the time it works. Why? Because the word is eternal, and the word never loses its power. So sometimes you quote the same scripture over and over again, it will never lose its power. And so by using that same scripture, every time that sin comes, you are creating a perimeter around your heart, around your mind, that every time that particular temptation comes, you answer it with the word of God. And therefore, you do away with that reproach. And folks, that is the key to victory. Living a life of victory, Jesus said, man does not live by bread alone, but by every debar, every word, every emra that comes from the mouth of God. And that's how he defeated the enemy. And so we too must stand ready at the window, protected and ready to answer the enemy when he comes to the window to try to put something inside. Answer him by the word of God, because that's where we trust. That's where we have our experience. And thus, we have victory because of the word of God. God bless you. Have a wonderful, spirit-filled day. And remember, thy word, O God, is truth. God bless.